Although we usually hear this Canon solo on the organ, it's actually scored for a bass line, plus three violins. No violins here. So Joy and I are going to share the parts to show you each one. Now, it starts with a ground bass. Joy's going to show you that with her feet. The ground bass continues 27 more times, which could get pretty tedious, except that there are amazing things happening on the top. The first thing we get is a tiny little theme that grows into a great set of variations. Here's the theme. Joy, would you care to join me with the ground bass?
Sure.
Thank you. Now here's where it all gets seriously clever. And I think the best way to show you how it works is with a little diagram. Here's Pachelbel's ground bass played by Joy's feet. It's going to continue to repeat unchanged all the way through the piece. Here is the main theme played by the first violin. As soon as it's finished, it plays a variation. Here is the main theme played by the second violin. As soon as it's finished, it plays the variation we've just heard with the first violin. Here is the main theme played by the third violin. As soon as it's finished, it plays the variations we've already heard. Each violin then follows the other with new variations until the end of the piece. Joy, shall we play the first few variations of the Pachelbel?
Sure.
Let's do it.
There you have a short excerpt of Pachelbel's Canon. Obviously, if you want to enjoy the entire piece on your very special day, you need not just a great organist like Joy, but three violinists in order to get the full, gorgeous effect of Pachelbel's delicate tapestry, his lines weaving around each other in celestial glory. Naturally, I recommend this. We should all support musicians. And of course, there are wonderful recordings out there for your further listening pleasure. One other curious thing that actually connects the far distant Pachelbel with this country. Pachelbel's son, Theodore, actually emigrated to the US sometime in the early 1700s and worked as a successful organist in Boston and Rhode Island before finally making his way all the way down to Charleston, South Carolina, where he lived as a respected organ teacher and composer until his death in 1750. History is amazing.
Joy, thank you so much for joining me. It's been a blast working with you.
You're welcome.
I'm off now to check out some more great classical music for my next video. Meanwhile,